Ashok Kumar was the first superstar of Hindi cinema as well as the first lead actor to play an anti-hero. He is widely regarded as a pioneering actor who introduced natural acting to Hindi cinema. He was born into a Bengali Hindu family in Bhagalpur, Bengal Presidency, British India, which is present-day Bihar. His original name was Kumudlal Ganguly.
His father, Kunjlal Ganguly, was a lawyer while his mother, Gauri Devi, was a homemaker.
His brothers, Anoop Kumar and Kishore Kumar, were also actors, and the three shared screen space in films like Chalti Ka Naam Gaadi and Badhti Ka Naam Daadi. Kishore Kumar was also a successful playback singer. Ashok Kumar stopped celebrating his birthday after Kishore Kumar died on that very day in 1987. Their only sister, Sati Devi, was married to Sashadhar Mukherjee, who worked in a fairly senior position in the technical department of Bombay Talkies, a pioneering Indian film studio.
Kumudlal's father wanted him to become a lawyer and got him enrolled in a law college. However, Kumudlal failed his exams and, to escape acrimony at home, came to live with his sister in Mumbai. He requested his brother-in-law to get him a job as a laboratory assistant at the studio. Kumudlal was successful at his job and loved his work. With the help of his brother-in-law, he managed to convince his father that he would not become successful as a lawyer and that he would be able to earn a living as a technician or lab assistant.
His acting career started purely by accident. Shooting was already underway on the Bombay Talkies production Jeevan Naya in 1936 when the male lead, Najmul Hasan, eloped with his co-star Devika Rani, who happened to be the wife of Himanshu Rai, millionaire owner of Bombay Talkies. She subsequently returned to her husband, who dismissed Hasan out of spite and summarily ordered Kumudlal to replace him, and that too against the advice of director Franz Austen, who felt that the young man did not have the good looks needed for an actor. Thus began the journey of Kumudlal as an actor. He was given the screen name Ashok Kumar in keeping with the general trend in an era when actors concealed their real identities behind screen names. His subsequent venture with Devika Rani in Achhoot Kanya the same year was one of the early blockbusters of Hindi cinema, and it cemented Ashok Kumar and Devika Rani as the most popular on-screen couple of that era, who went on to feature in many hits together. Back-to-back successes established him as one of the most bankable actors of the era. The Gyan Mukherjee-directed 1943 movie Kismet, featuring Ashok Kumar as the first anti-hero in Indian cinema, smashed all existing box office records, becoming the first Hindi movie to gross 1 crore at the box office. The movie's success made him the first superstar of Indian cinema.
In the words of the legendary writer Manto, Ashok's popularity grew each passing day. He seldom ventured out, but wherever he was spotted, he was mobbed. Traffic would come to a stop, and often the police would have to use lathis to disperse his fans.
After Kismet, he delivered a string of hits.
He also produced several films for Bombay Talkies during the final years of the company, including Ziddi in 1948, which established the careers of Dev Anand and Pran, Neel Kamal, which marked the debut of Raj Kumar, and Mehel in 1949, in which he co-starred with Madhubala.
With the advent of the 1950s, he switched over to more mature roles. And by the 1960s, he switched over to character roles, variously playing the parent, uncle, or grandparent, being careful never to be typecast. He received the Filmfare Best Actor Award for Rakhi in 1962. In 1968, he won a Filmfare Award as well as National Award in 1969 for the movie Aashirvaad. He acted in fewer films in the 1980s and 1990s and occasionally appeared on television, most famously anchoring the first Indian soap opera Hum Log and appearing as the title character in the series Bahadur Shah Zafar. His last release was the 1997 movie Aankhon Mein Tum Ho. He was honored with the Dada Saheb Phalke Award in 1988 and the Padma Bhushan in 1998 for his contributions to Indian cinema. At the age of 90, he died of heart failure at his residence in Chembur on 10 December 2001. The then Prime Minister Atal Bihari Vajpayee described him as an inspiration for many generations of aspiring actors.